Hi, I'm Donovan with another episode of Azure Friday. I'm here with Arturo, and we're going to learn about Azure AD Managed Service Identity. Welcome to the show.
Thank you, Donovan.
So what do you do here at Microsoft?
I'm a program manager in Azure Active Directory.
Okay.
I focus mainly on an offering of Azure AD, which is called Azure AD Managed Service Identity.
Managed Service Identity. So that's a mouthful. So
that is correct.
Why do I even care?
Azure AD MSI, or Managed Service Identity, allows Azure developers to be able to run workloads without needing credentials embedded in their code.
Okay. So this is going to help me get rid of that nightmare I have with service principles, expiration dates, and how do I use information, storing it in environment variables or web config files and having to transform all that stuff. All that goes away now.
That is correct.
Okay.
And this is for workloads that are running in, let's say, VMs, VM scale sets, app services, functions, where you need to put some sort of a credential there to be able to access, let's say, Key Vault or
okay.
SQL.
Okay.
And now you, as part of doing your code going forward, you're always having to remember, hey, I need to go back and rotate those credentials. I need to clean them up. Or in some cases, if you're going to push that code into some source code, you need to go and remove those credentials so that they don't get out there in the world.
Sure. Okay. So I'm going to be able to be, I'm an app running on a VM who needs access to Key Vault. And instead of me having to put in my web.config or environment variables, the service principal ID and key, I would then use MSI instead. And I think the beautiful part there is that if that extension, I mean that service principal expires, I don't have to redeploy my code or worry about it. I would just simply use the exact same MSI that I've always been using, and then all that magic happens in the back end to make sure that it can still have access to everything.
That is correct. So that's one of the big advantages of using MSI.
Okay.
Is that when before you had to worry about those expirations and all of that, that's now part of our job.
Okay.
What we will do in the background is make sure that, you know, whenever it's expiring, whenever we need to go and rotate credentials to make sure that everything is clean and safe, we will go ahead and do that.
Okay.
For you as a developer, nothing changes. You're basically
Perfect.
Calling the same endpoint and saying, you told me that I can get a token here. I want to continue to get a token, and there's nothing that needs to change.
Okay, you mentioned an endpoint. Why don't you show me how this works so I can see what this endpoint actually is.
So let's get this up, and so you'll be able to see. Here I'm in the Azure world, right? And the first thing I'm going to do is I want to note that MSI works just by default in most resources. In this case, we're going to be talking about VMs today. There's more other, you know, things like app services, like I mentioned before, or functions that also have support for MSI.
Okay.
And so what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go ahead and kick off a creation of a VM that will later enable MSI on it. So there's nothing special we need to do. So I'm going to call it, you know, Azure Friday, given that today is the session. And I'm going to go ahead and give it my username. I'm going to go use a password for now.
Okay.
And then I'm going to use an existing, I have a few different resource groups.
Sure.
And I'm going to pick, let's do WestUS2. Go ahead and go OK. And I'm going to default. Nothing special. I'll come back and change these settings later.
OK. So all we're doing here is creating a plain old VM. It could
plain
be Windows,
VM.
It could be Linux, it could be whatever.
That is correct. It can be Windows or Linux. It can be, you know, whatever configuration you want in whatever region you want.
Okay, perfect.
So we're going to go kick it off, and we're going to create. While that is happening, let me switch over really quick to the kind of commands that we're going to be using today.
Okay.
I didn't want to be messing up these commands, so I thought I'd put them out there.
and we can
talk about them. So at the top, I basically outlined what we're going to do. We are already past step number one, so we're already well ahead.
Okay.
For the rest of the demo, there's three main things we're going to do. One is I'm going to show you how to enable MSI,
okay,
just so that we can see that, hey, MSI is just a click of a button. It's super simple.
Okay.
The second thing is we're going to actually give it access to do something. When you enable MSI for a resource, it has access to nothing.
Got
right?
it.
You have no privilege, no permission. And so we need to go as a developer, as an admin, explicitly give it access to do something.
Perfect.
Today we're going to be using ARM, Azure Resource Manager.
Okay.
And then the last thing is once we have those two things set up, we can actually jump into an SSH session on the VM and go and call ARM and see what comes back.
Perfect.
Sounds good?
Sense. Yep.
So in order to allow for this VM to go to finish, I actually pre-provisioned a VM.
Perfect.
And this one is, again, just a vanilla VM. We're going to go under configuration. So today you're going to find MSI as a configuration.
Okay.
And so you can basically go and just click this yes. And you're going to click save.
All right.
And that's going to kick off the process to enable us.
So it's going to enable it. So is this also creating like an identity, or what is it actually doing by creating this?
So there's a few different steps that happen in the background. One is when you're enabling MSI, right? ARM, Azure Resource Manager, is the orchestrator.
Sure.
And so what that does is it calls Azure AD and says, hey, well, it actually calls MSI as a service. And then MSI will call Azure AD and say, hey, in the background, I actually need you to go to provision a service principle.
Got it.
Please go create that and tell me which one it is.
Okay.
Right? And then what we do at MSI is we marry that service principle with information about the MSI.
Okay, and this is per resource. So even if I have a resource group that might have four VMs in it and I wanted to enable MSI, I don't do it at the resource group level. I do it at the resource level.
That is correct.
So I'd have to turn it on like four times, for example.
That is correct.
Got
it. Okay. So today there's the ability for you to go and enable it by resource. Okay. Right? And so you would say, please give this resource an identity. Mm-hmm. The benefit of this is that when you enable it, that MSI is tied to the lifecycle of that resource.
Got it.
Let's say tomorrow you come in and you say, you know what, I want to get rid of this VM. You go delete the VM, we'll take care of everything.
Oh, the cleanup in the background.
We'll
Perfect.
Take care of the cleanup. Now, there's an upcoming feature that is going to be released, which is called Azure AD Managed Service Identity User Assigned Identities.
Okay, if you can make
different.
The lane longer, it'd probably make it a little easier for us to remember.
We will try it next time. User Assigned Identities are a variation of MSI, where now it's a standalone resource. And so instead of making it where you go to the resource and you say, please enable it, now you're going to go to the resource and say, here's the MSI I want you to use.
Perfect.
And so if I go and today delete this resource and tomorrow I need to create a new VM, I can now just point it to that.
Or I could deploy the same app on four different VMs and they all have access because they all have the exact same MSI.
That is correct.
Got it.
That is correct. So MSI has now been enabled.
Perfect.
Right? And so what we're going to do is, and as you can see, it's still deploying that other VM.
Sure.
I'm going to go ahead and we're going to jump back really quick. And so the next step is, I'm actually going to skip step number two in this list now that I've modified it, which is the granting of permissions.
Okay.
I'm going to go ahead and try using the MSI as it is right now, and let's see what happens.
All right.
Okay, so now what we're going to do is, I'm going to show you what it looks like to use it.
Okay.
And for that, I'm going to go ahead and use the Cloud Shell here. First, I'm going to go in here and pick out the information about the VM we need to connect to.
Okay.
And I'm just going to do a good old SSH session using the Cloud Shell.
Okay.
So we're going to go ahead and paste that in. And it will ask me for my password. Let's see if I remember it. And we're in. Okay, so we're in. I'm going to go ahead and maximize this because, again, we're now in that VM. Imagine that this is your code running in the VM.
Okay.
Right? And this is what your code would be doing.
Okay.
The first thing we need to do is let's go ahead and try to ask for a token. And I will show you that when we go ahead and do this, let's talk a little bit about what this call contains.
Okay.
Right? So the first piece of it is this HTTP 169.254.169.254. That is the address for the Azure Instance Metadata Service.
Okay.
Every Azure VM that is running, or basically any Azure VM, has access to the Instance Metadata Service, which is hosted on its host.
Okay.
Right? And so the Instance Metadata, or IMDS as we call it, has a few different endpoints that you can, or plugins that you can use, and one of which is identity.
Okay.
And what that enables us to do is that plugin is the one that actually runs all those background tasks, right? When we need to go rotate things, when we need to go and ask for credentials, that all is handled at that level.
Okay.
So in fact, whatever the service principle is in the credential never even makes it to the VM.
Got it.
Right? Now it's completely abstracted away. Okay. All you do is you're calling an endpoint and you're saying, please give me a token.
Got it. And that token I can then use in subsequent calls to get access to whatever resource I want.
Exactly. As long as the token is still valid.
Sure. You have to refresh it back. Just like you would any other token, right?
Exactly. Absolutely.
Okay.
And so what you're going to find here as well is that there's an extra parameter that is called resource. And this is what we're going to be asking for, right? So we're going to say, please give me a token so that I can go talk to management.azure.com.
Got it.
Which is the URL for talking to ARM.
Got it. So if I wanted to do something like Key Vault, the last part for the resource would be different.
Exactly. So it would be Vault,
and then
whatever the rest of the URL.
Okay.
The other thing to call out is that what we're doing here is really allowing to make a call to Azure AD.
Okay.
At the end of the day, these are Azure AD tokens. They're going through the IMDS host and then going over to Azure AD. And so there's nothing special about the token that is coming back.
Okay.
Right? It's just a good token. So call completed. Right, now let's go ahead and parse it. So in fact, let me go ahead and show you. If we do echo, and we're going to echo our response, what you're going to see here is there's the access token. is the entire body of it.
Okay.
Right. Not only do you have the access token, but you have all that good information about, you know, when does expire, before, after, and what's the resource that it's for.
Okay.
But in order to use it in our call, we actually need to go ahead and parse just the value of the access token. And that's what I'm going to be doing here.
Got it.
So we're going to go ahead and do that.
So even though we haven't used RBAC to give it permissions to anything, you still get a token back.
That is correct.
Yeah, so that's never going to give you like a 404. It's just that token has no permissions to do anything.
That is correct.
Got it.
It's okay. Basically saying, you want a token for that? Sure. Now go try to actually authorize that, right? Because there's other checks in place.
Sure. So this is basically just the authentication.
Yep.
I know who you are, and here's your token.
Yeah, that is correct.
Got it. And now we're going to do the authorization, which is completely different,
yes,
which a lot of people forget.
Right on point.
It's 2 point.
So we went ahead and got that. Now what I want to go and do is I'm going to construct the URL. And this URL is basically what we're going to do. And this would be what your code is
okay.
Really trying to achieve, right?
Got it.
In this case, what I'm trying to achieve is go and talk to ARM and read information about a resource group.
Okay.
And that's it, right?
Okay.
We're not
going to
do anything else special today. So I'm going to go ahead and copy that. Let me go construct that URL. And once it's ready, right now we have a URL that is ready. We have a token. We're ready to go.
Sure.
We're
going to
make the actual call, which is just a curl call. Now, what I'll call out is that while we're using curl right here, we do have support for you to go and use, let's say, an SDK, right? We have support through all the Azure SDKs to go ahead and use that.
Okay.
And then there's of course, you know, ways for you to go use it doing HTTP and all the good stuff. So we're going to go ahead and do that call. And if you see, it just returned, right? And it said, that's great. You don't have permissions.
Authorization failed, yep.
So sorry, but not sorry.
Sure, exactly.
And so what we're going to go is we've done all this. And as I mentioned earlier, we skipped basically step number two here.
Correct. Right? To prove that I can get a token, but that token doesn't have any permissions.
That is correct.
Now we're going to go grant it permissions. And next time we do this call, it won't be an authorization failed.
That's the goal.
Got it.
So we're
going to
go over here. We're going to go over here. And let's jump into resource groups. I'm going to pick my marketing prod resource group. And if we go under access control, I'm going to go ahead and add. And this is the very, you know, standard Azure RBAC experience.
Sure.
Right? There's only a subtle difference, and you're going to see that in a second. So I'm going to go and choose reader. I just want it to read. Normally, what you see here is you say, I want to assign access to an Azure AD user, a group, or an application.
Right?
This is now changed. Now what you're going to see is you're going to see all the other resources that are enabled to use MSI.
Got it.
Right. In this case, we have function apps, app services, virtual machines, and virtual machine scale sets. And so we're going to go and click on VMs. I'm going to go ahead and pick a subscription, which is the one that I'm running on. And then what you'll see here is when I say, hey, my VM is maybe running on marketing prod, there's going to be a list of all the VMs that currently have been enabled for MSI.
Got it.
Right? So it's not going to list just every VM. It's only the VMs that have an MSI identity.
Perfect.
So let's go ahead and pick Azure Friday, right?
Yep.
And then we're going to click Save.
And now it'll be added almost like a user here where I can then go apply the normal permissions.
So now if we go and scroll down, you'll see that Azure Friday is listed there.
As a reader.
So now let's go ahead back into the Cloud Shell, just to maximize it. And let's go execute that same call again and see what happens.
Got it.
And we got our response.
Absolutely, because the token didn't change, but the authorization of that token did.
Exactly.
So we didn't have to go back in and ask for another token or anything like that.
Right.
Cool.
And so if we wanted to go ahead and revoke those permissions, we can go and do that from the RBAC side.
Right.
And now the token will still be there, but it will no longer basically have access to that resource.
Perfect. And again, as a developer, the one thing that I hate dealing with service principles was the expiration.
Yes.
Eventually it expires, and I have to either go into my config file, I have to go somewhere close to my app and change the key or the ID of that service principle. And what you're telling me now is that should that service principle behind this MSI expire, this process is going to basically take care of renewing that, giving me a fresh one, and making sure it works. And the only way that only I ever have to worry about is RBAC like I would for anything else. The
correct.
Source principles are abstracted.
That is correct. As long as you have the MSI identity good to go, right, we'll handle all of the rotation and the renewals in the background. All you need to do is figure out what resources you need to have access to.
Perfect.
In the case of Azure Resource Manager, we have things like RBAC. There's other things out there that maybe don't have RBAC yet.
Okay.
Right? We also have a support for that. As long as you have a way to specify, here's a service principle, here's the ID that you need to give access to, we can support that. So it could look, you know, there's other patterns per se.
Got it.
So you could go to Key Vault, which does access policies, and go define an access policy that says, please accept tokens from this identity.
Got it.
Right? And so that's for anything that is running there. Now let's say, here's a little bit even farther, is that if you have a microservice that is running, right, and you have a way to interpret Azure AD tokens, you can enable that to understand these as well. Right?
Got it.
So it's not just services that we have there. It's any service that you really want to be able to understand that Azure AD token and can accept that and can validate it.
Awesome. So where do I go if I want to learn more about this? I know we send a lot of people to docs, so hopefully you're going to tell me docs.microsoft.com has what I need.
Yes.
Or can you show me what page that is?
Yes. So you can go to docs.microsoft.com. We also have a handy aka.ms Azure MSI.
Okay.
And that's going to send you right to the home page of our documentation.
Perfect.
And in here, you're going to find anything from how does it work, basically some more diagrams, and you can go and basically explore that to detail. There's tutorials. We have a lot of tutorials that we're putting together on, again, how do you do this with ARM and with a virtual machine or an app service, all that good stuff.
Okay.
And then there'll be more information about, hey, what's coming, as well as, you know, here's some of the things that we know about or are expecting to see.
Perfect. Thank you so much. We're learning all about Azure AD Managed Service Identities here on Azure Friday.